Anyway, Mr. McFadden.
I think Jim looks great in the tux. My name's Mike McFadden, and I'm running for the U.S. Senate because we can do better. We have to do better. And I wanted to hit something right out of the blocks here. I want everyone in this room to know that I'm strong on the Second Amendment, and I'm strong on life. And I want to counsel and caution everybody. Be wary of disinformation that is being sent out by other campaigns. And I want to make a commitment to each and every one of you. There will never, ever be anything from my campaign that talks about other Republicans, period. We have to stop this circular firing squad. We can do better. We have to stop beating each other up and start focusing on beating Senator Al Franken. I learned about hard work and sacrifice from my dad. My dad grew up on a dairy farm. He was the youngest of four kids. And when he was 6 years old, my grandfather died. And out of this tragedy came some great things. My Uncle John, who was 10 years older than my dad, at the age of 16, took over the farm. And with the help of my grandmother and neighbors, they were able to keep the farm. And you know what my uncle did for my dad? He paid for my dad to go to college. And that allowed my dad to be the first McFadden to have a college degree. And he went to work for the U.S. government, for IBM. He did the nuclear war planning for the U.S. government at Offutt Air Force Base. So that's how I ended up in Omaha. I was the oldest of five kids. One of the things that was always emphasized in our household, in our house, was education. Education was the way forward. And so when I was 18 and had an opportunity to go to college, I came up to the College of St. Thomas to play what I like to call Division VII football. Any Tommies in the room? All right. How about Johnnies? Any Johnnies? Okay, I'll make sure I stare directly at you and speak slowly. I might have lost a vote there. I love it. I love that rivalry. I love the Johnnies. I love the Tommies. I love the MIAC. I met my wife, Mary Kate. We've been very blessed. We have six children, five boys, and my daughter, Molly, who I like to describe as a rose surrounded by thorns. And one of the ways that I've always connected with my kids is through coaching. I love to coach. I've coached Molly in basketball. I've been the head football coach for the last 13 years in my town in the youth league. I've coached all five of my sons. And as a coach, I can tell you we absolutely have the wrong team on the field in Washington, D.C. We need to put Senator Franken on waivers. We need to send him home, wherever that might be, New York or California. He has the wrong game plan. He believes that the federal government is the solution for everything. And he's wrong, whether it be healthcare, education, or the economy. On healthcare, I want to take the fight to Al Franken. I want to ask him, Senator Franken, did you know that the president was lying when he told the American people that they could keep their healthcare plans? And what's he gonna say? He's gonna say no. So then I want to ask him, Senator Franken, would you still support Obamacare, knowing what you know today, that 140,000 Minnesota families would lose their healthcare plans, that the equivalent of 50,000 Minnesotans are gonna lose their jobs? On the economy, I couldn't have a bigger difference of opinion with Al Franken. He believes that government creates jobs. He's absolutely wrong. Government does not create jobs, businesses create jobs. On education, he believes the federal government's the solution for education. He couldn't be more wrong. We know that education done best is done locally. He is complicit with the worst outcomes in the country in Minnesota. We have the lowest graduation rate for minorities in the country. And that is wrong. And I know we can do better because I've been involved in an inner city school where 100% of our kids graduate and 78% go to college. We don't take any federal dollars. As your U.S. Senator, I'll work to get rid of Common Core, and I will work to have school choice. I want dollars going directly to the family. In conclusion, I'm not a politician, and I'm proud of that. I've always believed in a learn, earn, and then serve model. I believe the biggest single issue that we have in this country right now is we've created a professional class of politician, and it's killing us. It's not what the founding fathers envisioned. They would turn over in their graves. They wanted people later on in their careers, whether they be a business person or an educator, farmer, or a warrior, to go to Washington and serve. Underline the word serve. Go there to do something, not to be something. I promise you, as your next U.S. Senator from the great state of Minnesota, I will go to Washington to do something. I will fight for you. My name's Mike McFadden, and I'm running for the U.S. Senate. Thank you.